For this week's Tricky's Architects, I want to put a special spotlight on Joe, an amazing vocalist, vocal arranger, someone that I really feel gives a real look into what R&B culture, when people say that's R&B, I think they're talking about people like Joe. I think they're talking about people like SWV. I think they're talking about people like Brandy. But Joe really embodies the spirit of the culture as it pertains to being a singer. This is one of the favorite stories of our industry. So it's with great pleasure that I put a special spotlight on Tricky's Architects. This is Joe Edition. The way that I really look at people from whether I think they're a genius or whether I think they're like special or whatever the situation is, it's like, can somebody write for someone else? Like, is their gift singular to them? Because that's amazing. But when there's people that can step into the shoes of other people and write at the same level that they write for themselves, I've always been really, really impressed by that. Kenny Edmonds, I think, is my favorite of all time, of being able to step into other people's shoes and write hits, and Dream being a close second. But Joe had a way that he could do that. Joe wrote this record called The Softest Place on Earth on Escape. It sounded so expensive at the time. It sounded so rich. It sounded so polished and amazing, and it added a real R&B layer to their escape, in the sense that they had all these amazing hits, but JD was really coming at it from a hip hop standpoint of making an R&B group, and Joe made an R&B record as a great R&B singer with some amazing singers, and that record sounds so slick. It was on the Traces of My Lipstick album, I believe. But The Softest Place on Earth, one of my favorite productions and writings that he ever did outside of himself. Joe's vocal prowess, his ability to command a song, make you feel something, he's so important to our R&B culture. At the time when I first started hearing about Joe, it was because I was messing with Brian McKnight. And this is like, I don't know, 91, 92, early in my career. And I heard about Joe because Brian could obviously sing his ass off, but there was this other dude that everybody was saying that could sing his face off. And so it was a crazy time to see their careers go hit for hit, how they both evolved. Like, Joe became R&B, like he became the culture. Brian McKnight became the songs, like super big pop songs and crazy musicianship as a person who was almost like a jazz musician to start. But then once he hit One Last Cry, it was like boom. And Joe had those records too, but those records propelled him into our culture for a lifetime. And I just remember those two coming up around the same time, and that's like something that was really, really important to me, just watching two of the best R&B singers, two of the best singers in our culture that I've seen over that 25 to 30 year period. These are two of our top tiers. So, Joe, you gotta be a bad motherfucker to go by one name, and it'd be Joe. It's a bad boy. This is Tricky's Architects, and this is Joe's Edition. Follow us at Tricky Red Zone 1 on Spotify, Apple Music, and Tidal.